we can open this last session of interviews.
Yeah.
The yogis on Yavorie. And actually one yogi has to leave a bit earlier because he goes to Poland. So I won't be here for the Dhamma talk.
Uh-huh.
But I will let know people to kind of like close the Dhamma talk and already in advance I would like to thank you for your kind guidance and in sharing the Dhamma with us.
Yeah, okay.
So let's proceed to interviews. So if anybody is ready, we can start.
Hello, how are you?
Thank you. So I poprosím Lukáša.
Áno.
Myslela, teraz na záver som si dovolila už pustiť konceptuálnu myseľ a trošku som si zhrnula vlastne tento pobyt. No a prvá fáza bola, by som povedala, taká najúvoľnejšia, keď zaujímavé, že práve keď som prišla, tak na druhý deň sa mi, myslím, podarilo v chôdzi dosiahnuť na chvíľu ten stav, o ktorý sme sa mali pokúšať. A bola to pre mňa nová skúsenosť. Prvýkrát vedomé som niečo také zažila. A som za to veľmi vďačná. Teda pochopila som to tak, že vlastne oproti tej meditácii v sede ide o to, že napriek tomu, že stretáme viac pointov pri tej chôdzi, tak tá myseľ neuchopuje nič a proste je tam bohatosť tých podnetov oproti tomu sedu. Potom bola druhá fáza, keď som ďalší dní som bola taká ospalejšia. No a mala som pocit, že už to príde, že už sa upokojuje tá myseľ, že už taký moment badám, že už tá myseľ je ako keby priťahovaná nie tými podnetmi, ale ako sama sebou, hej. A ako taký magnet, že už sa jej nechce, už sa tak pustí. A, ale zistila som teda, že som ospala a že vlastne chodím po spiačky. A chcela som sa spýtať, že som nedosiahla ten stav ako tých prvení, že teda, že či má pre mňa mám nejakú radu. Tak neviem, či teraz zastane Lukáš.
Áno, dobre, ešte. Lepšie, hej, áno.
Dobre.
So I have been summarizing my overall stay here, the whole retreat, and what I can say is that in the first stage or in the beginning, I was most relaxed the day I arrived, and then especially the second day, I managed to enter or experience a kind of state that we were supposed to attain or recognize. And it was a new experience for me. Perhaps first time consciously in my life I have ever experienced something like that. So I'm very grateful for that kind of experience. And so I have understood that contrary to sitting meditation, in the walking meditation there is a variety of perceptions or phenomena, but mind nevertheless does not grasp onto anything. So there is this kind of richness of sensations, perceptions, which makes it different in comparison to sitting meditation. So then, in the second phase of my stay here, I was rather dull, I had a feeling that my mind occasionally is settling down, is calming down. And there were moments when it is more like resting in itself and not drawn into all the thoughts or perceptions that are arising. But I have noticed that I was quite kind of dull or sleepy. Even in the walking meditation, my mind tended to go towards sleepiness or dullness. So I was not able to enter or attain such kind of state like in the first day. So in this regard, would Bhante kindly offer me a piece of advice?
Yeah, I mean, basically this dullness, as I mentioned last time, so this is something you may start to experience, and it will slowly change actually. At the beginning it appear like dullness, but later it may slowly evolve and you may used to it, and again it is no more a kind of a dullness, rather it becomes a peacefulness. It's a kind of a peace in the mind. So mind is in a unagitated, fairly relaxed, non-grasping, and unassociated type of a state. And it is, so I mean, your perception start to evolve. So therefore it's nothing to worry, it's a matter of continuing your practice, your daily practice. So the daily practice will help you to overcome all these issues what you are mentioning.
Že v zásade táto opalosť, o ktorej si hovorila, to je tiež niečo, čo na začiatku takto môžeme vnímať, ale tiež je možné, že postupne sa naše vnímanie začne meniť, že ona sa spočiatku môže javiť ako opalosť, ale postupne sa môže zmeniť alebo rozvinúť na kľud mysle, keď je mysel usadená, není rozrušená, je hodne uvoľnená, nič neuchopuje, nespája sa s žiadnymi myšlienkami, čiže to je takto stav, sa môže rozvinúť, čiže není to niečo, s čím by si si mala robiť starosti, po sa trápiť, a skôr sa snaž pokračovať v každodennej meditačnej praxi a pokračuj, a to ti pomôže prekonať všetky tieto ťažkosti, o ktorých si sa zmienila.
No, čiže dá sa povedať, že treba pokračovať v tej meditácii a nie je jediným riešením lahnúť si spať na chvíľu.
Čiže, prepáč, ja som nerozumel dobre, že či je riešenie teda niekedy si spať?
Áno, alebo teda, že či je dobre sa snažiť to vlastne nejakým spôsobom preklenúť.
Uh-huh. Yes, okay. Like the right way to go for me is to continue in my meditation practice, and when I am getting drowsy or sleepy or dull, could a possible solution be just to have a nap, just to have a little sleep, or to try to overcome it and deal with it in the meditation?
Yeah, actually certain approaches are there. Now suppose, as I mentioned, when your mind is angry, your mind can't sleep. And when your mind is lustful, your mind can't sleep. And when your mind is overwhelmed by certain doubts, you can't sleep. So likewise, the defilements keep the mind kind of an agitated, awakened state. But now what we are going to do is something opposite. Here actually, mind is not interested in watching, purposely looking at certain things. Mind is not interested in purposely, deliberately hearing certain things. So likewise, now mind is becoming dispassionate, not interested in so many things. As a result, what you feel is some sort of a dullness. So this is kind of a, say, rich kind of a dullness. So here actually you got to slowly familiarize with it. So don't immediately go to sleep. Say yesterday, if you are able to stay in that state for 15 minutes, at least try to be with it 20 minutes today, say 25 minutes tomorrow. So likewise, little by little, try to sort of be patient with it. Then only you are able to overcome this issue, and you start to experience the peacefulness then.
Ako som spomínal, keď je mysel plná hnevu, tak my nedokážeme zaspať, alebo spať. Keď je plná chtivosti, túžby, tiež sa nedá spať. pokiaľ si je ovládaná pochybnosťami, opäť nemá kľud a nespí. Čiže tieto nečistoty, oni rozrušujú myseľ a to sa bežne deje v našom bdelom stave. Čiže tu sa snažíme robiť, alebo tu robíme niečo opačné, čiže myseľ sa nezaujíma o, ona sa nezaoberá o to, čo vidíme, nezaujíma sa o to, čo počujeme a týmto spôsobom myseľ sa stáva odpútanou. A ona sa nezaujíma o to dianie a výsledkom toho sa môže objaviť určitá akoby ospalosť alebo akoby nejaká tupost, avšak je to akási bohatá tupost, ktorú keď človek akoby zotrvá, tak sa ona sa zmení na taký hlbší kľud. A čiže to znamená, že není dobré ísť hneď spať. Isté, že keď napríklad v takomto stave dokážeš zotrvávať teraz napríklad 15 minút, tak zajtra skús ňom byť 20 minút. Pozajtra 25 minút. Čiže s trpezlivosťou pomaly postupne. Potom túto ťažkosť, túto prekážku dokážeš prekonať a rozvinieš, budeš zažívať viac ten pokojný, mieruplný, kľudný stav.
Thank you very much. A ešte vlastne teda posledná vec, aby som dala aj priestor ostatným, tak vlastne tá tretia fáza bola až do dnes je taká, že mám taký zrýchlený tepy duši, trochu srdce a toto mám, ako som myslím už spomínala, aj veľmi často a niekedy to trvá aj veľmi dlho, aj keď teraz sa skracujú u mňa tie fázy, čo som rada. No a takže pre mňa je otázka, tak skúmam to vlastne, že nakoľko sa dá kľudiť toto srdce vďaka tejto technike. Dobre je, že som si všimla vlastne, že do istého bodu sa to naozaj dá ukľudniť a síce do takého bodu, že tie myšlienky sú veľmi spomalené, sú veľké medzery medzi tými myšlienkami alebo jednotlivými iba slovami, že sa to vie úplne spomaliť, ale vlastne niekedy to ostane takto a už si neviem pohnúť, je tá my ako keby pokojná, ale na tej fyzickej úrovni stále cítim, že je nejaké napätie.
And the last So and the last thing that I would like to mention, also to give enough space for others, is that now I am still in the third phase or stage of the retreat. Until today, I have been having some little difficulties with palpitation of heart. And which I am having quite often or for a long time, even though those stages or phases when it is overwhelming or uncomfortable are being reduced. And so now my first question, this question is that when I am examining how much this method or technique can help me to reduce, to help me with that problem with the heart beating, strong heart beating. So, and it's good that I have managed to become slightly calmer, to get some kind of calm, and my thoughts are slowed down, and I can see also gaps between thoughts or between the words. I'm able to slow it down in that way, sometimes I cannot go further. I don't know how to go further, go on. So my mind stays calm, but on the physical level, I still keep having some kind of tension in my physical body.
Yeah, so basically, as you mentioned, if the gap between the thoughts are increasing, so that is a good sign. And as much as possible, allow it to happen and let the thoughts to disappear go away quickly, and you got to appreciate that gap, that kind of emptiness in between the thoughts. So as you are continuing that emptiness, there is nothing there in between the thoughts, so that improves and that increases, and that that has to be your refuge. That is the sort of the place that we have to stay as much as possible, since we are developing it. Actually, later, as we discussed on yesterday, we can allow various thoughts and sights, sounds, etc., to even disturb that, and again then return to that. So that is the kind of a practice that we discussed yesterday. So that is in when you are developing that, so you don't need to actually hold the vibration of the heart. Actually, while you are maintaining that balance, equanimous state, what we are discussing now, that is the priority. And you don't need to again go back and look at the heart vibration. So then actually it may appear like really huge, unbearable, because your mind is already sharpened and highly concentrated. And with that, if you go and again watch the heart vibration, so it is sometimes become unbearable. So you don't need to actually watch that, rather familiarize with that emptiness.
V zásade, keďže si, ako si povedala, keď dokážeš vnímať túto medzeru medzi myšlienkami, to je dobré znamenie. Teraz sa snaž, alebo skúšaj ju čo najviac predĺžovať. A buď v tomto stave, kedy sa myšlienky rozpúšťajú. Čiže oceňovať, tiež je dôležité vážiť si, alebo oceňovať túto medzeru medzi myšlienkami, alebo túto prázdnotu. A potom, ako budeš pokračovať v tomto stave prázdnoty, tak to tak budeš vidieť, ako sa akoby tvoja prax zlepšuje a že sa zvyšuje sa tvoja schopnosť byť v tomto stave, v tejto medzere, v tejto prázdnote, a tu by si tiež mala vnímať ako svoje útočisko, ako miesto, kde zotrvávať a spočívať v ňom čo najviac a rozvíjať ho. Čiže potom, keď to dokážeš, tak môžeš aj dovoliť rôznym myšlienkám a vnemom, zvukom, nech vyvstávajú a oni už nebudú rušiť, ktoré budú rozptýlovať. Čiže o tomto sme diskutovali včera. Oni sa vždy vrátia späť do tejto prázdnoty. Čiže keď to dokážeš rozvíjať, tak není treba, aby si sa zaoberala tým bušením srdca alebo zrýchleným tepom. Čiže skôr sa snaž udržiavať akúsi vnútornú rovnováhu a vyrovnanosť, to je priorita. A vidíte, že teraz, keď si už dosť rozvinula všímavosť a sústredenie, tak potom, keď máš takúto ostrosť, jasnosť v mysle, tak vidíte, že keď ju zameriaš na srdce, na buškenie srdca, tak sa ti zdá, že buší, alebo že je intenzívnejšie ten puls, avšak ty sa týmto nemusíš zaoberať. Pretože ak sa tým budeš príliš zaoberať, tak sa to stane akoby neznesiteľné pre tvoju myseľ. Čiže ty to môžeš iba pozorovať, ale skôr, čo by si mala robiť, je sa viac a viac oboznamovať alebo rozvíjať cenosť prázdnoty.
Thank you very much. I have some questions. Philosophical question. I'm overtaking the time, probably, but if I may ask, I will be grateful for every insight or glimpse.
Right.
And I also try to summarize a little bit what we have been doing all the time. And I realize, as you said many times, that all the time we are coming back to our mind, so that we are leaving the world as it is
and we are also leaving the people as they are. As you said, that when we have some reaction inside, the best is like to take one step back and observe and notice. And when I was asking that question, then when mind really comes to itself, completely resting and peaceful and silent and calm, then what happens to the world and people? Because I have this strong feeling and experience of this interconnection and interrelatedness. And you notice that everything becomes a little bit like more like in the flux, in the movement, that it's probably a little bit, it's not so stable or not so solid what we see around, that it's maybe a little bit like more moving and vibrating. But I also read one sentence before this retreat and it's resonating with me, that finally the world we see, it's all mental functions, what is outside. So my question is, what do you think?
Yeah. So basically, so as you mentioned, as we are growing in the vipassana, so the boundaries start to disappear. Now there's a boundary in the mind, say when you are keeping your body in a particular posture and we have some sort of a boundary of the body. But this boundary start to disappear and become kind of a blurred. And even when your eyes are open, it is not now focused onto a very narrow area, onto a particular object. Rather, it is not established in any place. Now, likewise, now we are connected to the whole universe, we can say. Even though we are not holding anything, not grasping anything, we actually have become part of the whole universe. So this is kind of a different experience, we can say. Previously, we were narrowed down our mind. We have focused to someone, something. As a result of that, we also have become narrowed down. So we also become quite constrained, restricted. But now the mind is quite open and not holding anything. And there is enough space in the mind. Quite freedom is there. So the whole universe and ourselves have become somewhat one thing. So this kind of experience is possible. So therefore, so you may experience, even you being alone, you don't feel loneliness. Now you assume that you are meditating alone, but you feel connected with the whole universe. You don't feel loneliness. And you feel some sort of connectedness with the whole, or everyone else and every whole, say the environment and everything. It's a kind of a becoming humble and connected with everything. So this is something that we can actually explore.
Thank you. Thank you very much. And thank you for the whole retreat. Like, it was amazing experience. And now I mean amazing, like amazing. That was really very eye-opening. And also minds opening. So thank you very much.
Okay, you're welcome. Wish you all the best. Yes, good morning.
Good morning, Lucas. Natalia speaking.
would I look out for translation?
Okay.
Thank you. Pokračuji v praxi všímavosti. Klid se prohlubuje během meditace, chůze, sledují charakteristiku elementů. Je to, řekněme, ten typ pocity měkkosti, tvrdosti, vázkosti, lehkosti jsou intenzivnější. Pokud přijde nějaká myšlenka, podívám se na ní a vracím se zpátky. Mysl ale stále ještě není stabilní a všimnu si, že do myšlenky se někdy více zapletu, ale i potom si toho všimnu a jdu na tělo, kde sleduji vlastně, co to s tím tělem udělalo. Ať už je to nějaký tlak v hlavě, nebo stuhnutí těla, nebo jakýsi druh ohně, který mi jde po páteři do hlavy. Během meditace sezení se projevuje ten stav podobně, to znamená, jsou meditace, které mám velmi klidné a umožní mě to vyvstát dobrou koncentraci, která mi umožní jít do stavu snad možno označit jako prázdnoty. Zatím se mi to podařilo jednou nebo dvakrát. A poprvní to byl moment, který mě, řekněme, fascinoval, nebo fascinoval. Byla jsem překvapená, že tam opravdu jako vůbec nic není. A zkusila jsem jít do Choiceless Awareness, kde se rozběhl proud mnoha jevů. Tak jsem se zase vrátila zpátky a zase tam nic nebylo. Tam jsem se trvávala nějakou chvíli, 10-15 minut, už mě to přestalo bavit, tak jsem se vrátila zpátky na primární meditační předmět zvedání a klesání a pokračovala teda v běžné praxi sledování teda sekundáru.
I have been continuing my practice of mindfulness with increased calm. So during the walking meditation, I have been watching characteristics of elements, feelings or sensation of softness, hardness, lightness, getting more intense. Occasionally a thought would disturb me or distract me, and then when I realized that, I came back, I returned. So my mind is still not stable. Thoughts do occur, and sometimes I'm getting entangled, but then I'm recognizing, I'm noticing that, and then I come back to my body and watching what is the impact of that kind of distraction or that trip on my body. So whether it is a kind of talk in my head, or my body getting more stiff, or some sensation of burning fire in my spine going upwards towards the head. So during the sitting meditation, I'm experiencing a kind of state that is similar, but my meditations are rather calm, and it enables me to have a fairly good concentration, thanks to which I'm able to remain in the state of emptiness, or a kind of state that I kind of label as emptiness. So far, I have managed one or two times to enter or to experience that kind of state. And the first time, I was fascinated and surprised that indeed there is nothing at all in that state, in that condition. So from there, I have tried to enter or apply a choiceless awareness. But a variety of phenomena occurred or manifested, so I returned back to that emptiness, and there was nothing there. So I have stayed there for about 10 to 15 minutes, and when I was a little kind of tired or fed up staying there, then I again returned to the primary object, which is rise and fall, and rising and falling, and then I continued in the my common practice of watching the secondary object, secondary meditation.
Okay, good. So basically, so recognizing, say, rising and falling is okay. I mean, all these things, all these observations further enhance our understanding, wisdom. And once they are maturing, again, it will allow us to plunge onto that emptiness. Basically, as we improve wisdom, so it allows the mind to let go of the grasping. So then where we are landing upon is that the emptiness. So you can do it using Vedananupassana, you can do it using Kayanupassana, you can do it using Chittanupassana. So anyway, the landing point where we are going and merging is basically have no grasping.
A klesania je v poriadku, aj všetky tie pozorovania a vhľady, ktoré si rozvinula a popísala, keď nám pomáhajú rozvinúť múdrosť a pochopenie, tak je to veľmi dobré. Čiže všetky tieto veci nám nakoniec pomáhajú sa ponoriť do prázdnoty, alebo nám umožňujú, dovolujú nám sa ponoriť do prázdnoty. Čiže ak dozreje múdrosť, tak ona nám umožní opustiť uchopovanie, prestať uchopovať a vďaka tomu my pristaneme v prázdnote. Čiže či už sa zameriavame na telo, alebo pocity v nemi, alebo na mysel, alebo teda robíme kaja, vedatná, alebo čitánu pacana, tak nakoniec tým miestom alebo bodom, kde pristaneme, je prázdnota, stav mysle, kde není žiadne uchopovanie ničoho.
Mám jednu otázku, na kterou částečně můžu najít i odpověď v předešlé výpovědi Banteho, ale chci se zeptat, jaký je rozdíl mezi nibánou, stavem bez znaků, jakýmsi stavem prázdnoty a dosažení tohoto stavu setrvávání a návratem k primárnímu meditačnímu předmětu.
I am having a question that has perhaps been answered by you in the previous answer. Let me ask, what is the difference between Nibbana and the state of emptiness and the state without characteristics and the attainment of such kind of state remaining there or resting there and between coming back to the primary meditation object?
Yeah, interesting question. So actually, when we get a kind of a formal definition for Nibbana, so Buddha give a kind of a phrase where all the formations have to calm down. So there can't be any fabrications, there can't be any formations, constructions. So that all sankhara, the formations have to calm down. So that is one aspect. Then completely the craving has to be let go of. And again, it is a kind of a sublime, calm, tranquil state. And again, the lust, hatred, delusion also have to be completely uprooted. So what we are experiencing as emptiness have some qualities of that, but still latent tendencies are there, remain in the mind. So therefore, our experience is not yet stable, we can say, because it can't last for a long time, because still the potential is there for various defilements to arise. But the path to reach that Nibbana is the same thing that we are discussing, where we have to maintain calmness, where we have to maintain non-grasping state, and we have to allow various disturbance to happen because of these latent tendencies, the defilements. And then we recognize these defilements and we are not nourishing them, we are not promoting them, and we allow them to fade away. So we are weakening them, in other terms. So more and more, so the mind become peaceful, more and more the less and less, stress, tension, mind become calm. So this is how it is actually growing. So therefore it is sometimes mentioned as a kind of a temporary kind of a Nibbana. It is not the full-fledged Nibbana, but the temporary kind of Nibbana that what we are experiencing. It is sometimes, in Pali, it is called as Tadanga Nibbuti. So it's a temporary cessation.
Ten zaujímavá otázka a v skutočnosti Buddha hovorí, že Nibbana je stav, v ktorom ustali všetky formácie, všetky stankári sa skľudnili, v ňom nie sú žiadne výtvory v mysle, žiadne fabrikácie, tie sa všetky oslobodili alebo skľudnili, taktiež v ňom není žiadna forma chtivosti a pripútanosti. Je to vznešený stav kľudu, pokoja. Je tiež slobodný od akéhokoľvek hnevu, odporu, klamu. Tieto sklony mysle boli úplne vykorenené. Avšak to, čo my zažívame ako prázdnotu, má určitú charakteristiku alebo kvalitu tiež nibány tohto stavu, avšak naďalej máme svoje skryté tendencie mysli, ktoré vyvstávajú. Čiže naša skúsenosť ešte není stabilná a netrvá dlho, pretože stále máme potenciál rôznych nečistôt, ktoré vyvstávajú. Avšak tá cesta k Nibbáne je rovnaká, tá je taká istá, čiže my musíme objaviť tento stav prázdnoty a potom dovoliť rôznym nečistotám, nech sa objavujú, a tým, že ich neuchopujeme, tak oni sa rozpúšťajú, oni odchádzajú a tým sa stávame ešte viac uvoľnení, kľudní, máme menej stresu, menej napätia a týmto spôsobom nás rastie tento kľud a preto sa to niekedy tiež označuje ako dočasná Nibbána. Není to ešte plná alebo úplná konečná Nibbána a v Pali sa používa tento pojem, ktorý ste od mňa povedal, niečo ako, čo znamená dočasný zánik, ustanie.
Thank you for your answer and thank you for your leading, Bhante. It was amazing all the all sessions. Thank you.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, welcome.
And thank you, Lucas, for the translation.
Yeah.
Well, thank you very much.
Speaking?
Yes, yes.
I will ask Lucas for translation of Bhante's answers.
Okay.
First thing, I'm not leaving the retreat today. I'm going to be here till Friday evening. So it's information for you. So I continue with meditation now. concerning to the fraction. I'm settling in the state of mind when a mind doesn't grip anything, and it's very uncomplicated. There is no formation in that state, and several moments, sometimes it's minutes or tens of minutes, some defilements come, and I recognize it, and I choose one of two ways. First way is that I abandon it, as you mentioned yesterday during your Dhamma presentation. So I abandon it as it's useless, and I let it go out. Or a second way is that I watch it, I look at it, usually cases I watch bodies, phenomena, for example, some vibration, some changing of position. Usually I watch it around the belly, in my neck, in my head, in my face, sometimes in legs, in hands. So that's my practice nowadays, and slowly I discover these defilements and I clean it.
Yeah, good. So you are doing well. So it's a slow process actually. We can't expedite the process. Rather, we have to just continue our practice. We have to continue the daily practice, and various circumstances are arising, and then accordingly we have to properly, as we discussed yesterday, again and again return back to the non-grasping state, so that that becomes our second nature. That becomes almost like the first nature. So that is where actually Buddha very clearly mentioned, pabassana midam bhikkave cittam tanchako agantukehi upakkilesehi upakkilitta. In Pali, what it says is that the original nature of the mind is quite pure, non-grasping. There is no tension there. Because of the intruding defilements, so it gets impure. So it becomes polluted. But when we start to recognize this process, how our purity being lost, how the calmness being lost, how the unattached state again become attached, and how the unfabricated state again become fabricated, constructed. So then we are slowly sort of improving our wisdom, and we are sort of not promoting that process, not promoting fabrications, not promoting holding things, not promoting getting agitated, not promoting any lust, hatred, delusion. So rather we have a kind of an inclination towards resting in that calmness, tranquility, non-grasping state.
Ano, to je dobré, robíš to dobré. Je to pomalý proces, ktorý sa nedá nejak úplne urýchliť. Iba pokračuj v dennej praxi. A podľa toho, aké okolnosti v dennom živote budeš mať. Čiže snaž sa znovu a znovu sa vrácať do tohoto stavu neuchopovania, a ktorý by sa mal stať našou druhou povahou alebo našou skutočnou povahou. V Pali, stihodný povedal tento verš Pali, ktorý znamená, že naša pôvodná mysel alebo táto pôvodná podstata mysle je čistá, je bez uchopovania, je bez napätia, je avšak pôsobením dočasných nečistôt sa stane poškvrnenou alebo zastretou. Avšak ak my vidíme, čo spôsobuje, ak akoby s múdrosťou vidíme tento proces, čo spôsobuje, že nevytvorená táto nevytvorený stav sa stáva vytvorený, odputaný stav sa stáva priputaný, to, čo je nevykonštruované, sa stáva vykonštruovaným. Takže keď toto vidíme vďaka postupnému rozvoju múdrosti, tak potom už my neživíme tento proces uchopovania a nečisťovania mysle a potom sa tieto rôzne vytvory mysle a taktiež nečistoty, rozrušenie, chtivosť, hnev, klam sa ukludnia, uvoľnia a my viac inklinujeme k spočívaniu v kľude v stave bez napätia, bez uchopovania.
I understand and I feel it safe. So thank you very much, Bhante.
Yeah, good, good. Then you answer nice. May you be well and happy.
So hello, Bhante, once more.
Yeah, welcome.
When we have time, I am not sure how we are with time.
Now we have but 10 more minutes. We have.
At 10 minutes, I think.
Okay.
Yesterday I tried to do what you said me. So. Takže poprosím ešte Lukáša. Snažila som sa teda predĺžovať tie medzery. A zaujímavé bolo teda, že to, čo bolo rušivé, tie slova, začal som vnímať v nich priestor a ticho. Potenciál priestoru a ticha.
I have been trying to apply the instructions you gave me yesterday, so I try to extend those gaps between thoughts. And what was interesting was that all the words, what was disturbing the words, instead of dwelling in them, I could see or perceive that potential of space and silence.
Yeah, good.
Mám jednu otázku. Všimla som si totiž vonku, keď som chodila. Chodila som do kruhu. A keď som potom išla do miestnosti, včera som to skúšala tak prvýkrát, že som vlastne išla jednu priamku, zastavila sa, otočila, išla naspäť. No a keď už som sa dostávala do toho štádia, že pár sekúnd bolo to ticho, alebo už aj možno takú tú, možno celú dĺžku alebo polku dĺžky proste, bolo to ticho, ale vyrušilo ma, keď som sa mala otočiť, lebo všimla som si teda, že oči sú úplne relaxované, nežmúrkajú, nepotrebujú už žmúrkať a človek je vlastne v takomto inom stave a vtedy sa to vlastne preruší pri tej otočke.
So while doing the walking meditation, I have observed that when I was going in a circle, I did not have such kind of problem as I had when I was going there and front in one line, which was in the room inside. But I was going in a circle outside, so then inside, going in one line, going back and forth. So that what happened, that I could experience that kind of peace or silence, perhaps half of the time of my walking path, I could be in that calm and silence. But then I was disturbed by the point where I was about to move, to turn around. So I observed that my eyes are fairly relaxed, not blinking. But in that state, when I was supposed to turn around and go back, I was disturbed by that event, that
yeah.
turning.
Yeah, so actually these are called posture junctions. So certain turning points and certain changing from one posture to the other posture. On these junctions, actually, there's a possibility of breaking the even the mindfulness, and we actually lose mindfulness. Oh, and here in this situation, probably we again get certain thoughts to the mind. So that calmness, emptiness also have a little interrupted. But with time, these things will sort of calm down, and you be able to even handle these posture junctions successfully. So it will be sorted out.
Ano, to sa nazýva zmena pozícií, čiže keď dochádza k takéto zmene pozícií, tak tieto zmeny sú možnosťou, kde práve niekedy ľahšie stratíme všímavosť. Naša všímavosť sa stráti, sa preruší, a v takejto situácii tiež sme možno ľahšie unášaný myšlienkami a strácame kľud a prázdnotu, čiže dojde k akému si malému prerušeniu. Avšak keď sa snažíme a keď praktikujeme, pokračujeme v praxi, tak aj toto sa akoby uvoľní, alebo sa to skľudní, my to prekonáme a budeme schopní dobre zvládať aj takéto zmeny pozície, bez toho, že by nás rozptýlili alebo vyrušili, čiže s pokračovaním praxe to budeš schopná prekonať.
Thank you. A ešte by som sa chcela spýtať, že asi individuálne určite bude prichádzať na to využívať vypasanú aj v bežnom živote, ale predsa by ma zaujímalo, keď používa človek napríklad v práci analytickú konceptuálnu mysel, akým spôsobom to pracuje, alebo akým spôsobom sa to dá využiť. No, také niečo.
I'm interested to learn how to apply the Vipassana meditation in everyday life. Especially I'm interested to know if, suppose in my work, in my job, I'm using a lot analytical mind, conceptual mind, in which way can I use the Vipassana meditation in this case, in this regard?
Yeah, it's a good question. Actually, suppose you are using computers, now rather than staying on the screen for a long time, so say time to time come back to yourself. Time to time, just if possible, even stop working for 5 minutes and again return back to your body. So basically, we are simplifying ourselves, because if you are in conceptual imaginations and sort of very brainy activity, so it consumes a lot of energy, it generates a lot of tension. And again, we are in the proliferation sometimes. But time to time, we have to remind ourselves, okay, now I am sitting. Now I am keeping my, focus on my breath or rising and falling. So this is, again, we are connecting to that simple, direct experience. So that way we can actually remove the already developed tension and remove that conceptual proliferation. Again, calm down ourselves. And reduce thinking, again come back and establish ourselves in emptiness. So this is one approach, and let Lucas translate that, and we'll discuss further.
Je to dobrá otázka. Napríklad, keď pracuješ, sedíš za počítačom, tak miesto toho, aby si stále pozeral do obrazovky dlhý čas, tak je dobré z času na čas sa vrátiť späť k sebe. Napríklad na chvíľku prestať pracovať, vrátiť sa k telu a byť akoby v takom prostom, jednoduchom bytí sama so sebou. Čiže, pretože takáto trvalá alebo neustála konceptuálna aktivita mysle, kedy stále iba používame mozog, konzumuje, spotrebová veľa naše energie a taktiež spôsobuje veľa napätia. Čiže z času na čas si človek sa akoby uvedomí alebo sa vráti späť k sebe, k tomu, že teraz sedím. Napríklad sa môže zamerať na dých, na zdvíhanie, klesanie, alebo sa iba spojiť s priamou bezprostrednou skúsenosťou toho prítomného okamihu. Čiže týmto spôsobom môže odstrániť už vystalé napätia alebo konceptuálne bujnenie mysle a skľudniť sa a umenšiť akoby dominanciu myslenia a opäť sa vrátiť späť k sebe a ustanoviť tento kľudnejší stav. Čiže toto je jeden prístup.
So on the other hand, suppose you are talking with someone. At that time, you can check your mind. So all the activities, actually, we have to have separate ongoing watching, observation of our mind. If you are talking with someone, is there any resentment arising in our mind? Is there any kind of an agitation arising in our mind? Is there any attachment growing in our mind? Is there any kind of a revengeful thoughts growing in our mind? Am I trying to suppress this other person? Am I trying to show off myself during this conversation? So likewise, various ways of how our mind reacting to this situation can be observed. Similarly, all the other activities also, we can watch our mind and see how the mind is handling this situation. So there are actually, we are recognizing various subtle defilements and not being victimized to them. So we are taking correct decisions, we are correct taking the proper way of action without being a victim to those defilements.
Na druhej strane, keď napríklad s niekým rozprávame, tak môžeme vždy sa pozerať na svoju mysel, byť si vedomý, čo sa v našej mysli deje aj počas toho, ako rozprávame. Čiže my sa snažíme kontinuálne pozorovať svoju myseľ, byť si vedomý, čo sa v mysli deje. Takže aj keď s niekým hovoríme, tak či je v mysli nejaký hnev, či je nejaká pripútanosť, alebo máme nejaké myšlienky spojené s pomstichtivosťou, alebo chceme toho druhého človeka nejak zmanipulovať, alebo ho niekam dotlačiť, alebo sa chceme pred týmto človekom predvádzať. Čiže týmto spôsobom sledujeme, ako mysel reaguje v takéto situácii a toto vždy môžeme toto pozorovať. Čiže tiež vidíme, ako mysel zvláda situácie, ako na ne reaguje a my rozpoznávame jemné nečistoty a už nie sme ich obeťou, ale akoby máme alebo robíme správne rozhodnutia. Čiže bez toho, že by sme boli obeťou nečistôt, tak jednáme vlastne správne.
And on the other hand, once we did something, there could be certain thoughts later arising in our mind, making a self, making a personality. So that also, if we can recognize, that is also good. Say for example, you help someone. And after coming back home, so there are certain thoughts arising in the mind telling that I am the one who helped him, and if not I am, so he was in a big trouble. So it's kind of a self-praising kind of thoughts. So there also we can understand how the mind is trying to make a self, build a self, construct a self. So that also we can disclaim and keep the mind quiet. So this minimizing conceptual proliferation is a must in our practice.
Napríklad niečo dobré, ale potom, keď sa mysel vracia k tejto situácii a ustanovuje pocit seba, čiže napríklad sme niekomu pomohli a teraz prídeme domov a hovoríme si, že dobre som to spravil, som mu pomohol, kebyže mu nepomôžem, tak by bol mal veľké problémy, čiže akési myšlienky spojené so sebe chválou. Čiže my tiež toto môžeme rozpoznať a môžeme si uvedomiť, ako sa mysel buduje pocit seba, vykonštruuje pocit ja, pocit seba. A opäť toto je niečo, čo môžeme nechať odísť a udržiavať mysel tichú alebo jednoduchú. Čiže naozaj v našej praxi je nevyhnutné minimalizovať, umenšovať bujnenie konceptuálnej mysle.
Ďakujem. Nie, myslím, že nielen pre veľmi cenné boli tieto odpovede a som zvedavá už na to, čo bude ďalej pri praxi a myslím, že pre nás všetkých to bolo veľmi zaujímavé a taktiež sa chcem poďakovať za veľmi podnetné dramatoky. Pre všetko dobré aj vám.
So thank you very much. I am looking forward to how my practice is going to evolve and I'm sure it was very fruitful and beneficial for all of us to hear it. And I am also looking forward to your next Dhamma talk. Thank you very much.
Okay, you are welcome. Okay, I think we have reached 1 hour. If there is no any other person to talk, we can wind up the session.
Thank you very much, Bhante.
Okay.
Yeah, thank you very much, Bhante.
Okay, you are welcome. So see you at 4:30.
Sadhu, sadhu,
sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu,
sadhu, sadhu, sadhu,
sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadhu, sadh